Well, hi kids. I'm showing TeaCache and Draw Things. Draw Things is image and video generation for Apple Silicon. It's free on the app stores for Mac and iOS. TeaCache works with FluxDev and the recent video models, Hunyuan and Juan. I'm gonna share a strategy with you. There are actually two options. You can render faster at worse quality. You get faster rendering, but everyone else is just seeing a worse quality render. That's not what you want to show. Or get better quality for the same amount of work, maybe even a little less. So the strategy is you want steps. Steps are good. TeaCache lets you add more steps for no cost, and that's a level up that everybody else can see because the results are better. But on the other hand, only you know if you rendered fast or not. You can brag about it online, but everybody else only sees the end results, which might have lost some quality. You see the problem there. The simple explanation is TeaCache is an accelerator that intelligently skips render steps. Now, if you've used an acceleration, LoRa, or a Lightning or Turbo model, we adjust the steps lower from around 30 to 40 steps on a normal model down to 15 or maybe 8 steps accelerated. The computer doesn't actually get faster. The model is just rendering in fewer steps. But with TeaCache, we don't set the step count lower. Instead, we set a threshold level, and TeaCache decides which steps can be skipped based on how much they change. I'm gonna do the tutorial first. There's nothing to set up, so you can start using it right away. Afterwards, I will explain strategies to get the most out of TeaCache, and this is gonna be a pretty short video. Now, inside Draw Things, for certain models, official and community models, TeaCache will be an option down at the bottom of the full menu. It's just for Flux-based architecture, at least so far, and that includes Schnell and its derivatives. But Schnell is already accelerated to 4 steps, so don't expect miracles. It will not appear in SDXL or SD3.5, but it will appear under Hunyuan video. I see it on my Hunyuan fast video import. And TeaCache also appears under the official Juan video model, and we just got Juan imports and LoRa's, including the fun model. I'm putting that in a new video coming up, so subscribe, blah blah blah. But at the time, those Juan imports don't actually show the TeaCache because of some kind of coefficient calculation thing I don't really understand. But to use TeaCache, just enable it. The start and end times correspond to your step count. Typically leave the start at 5, and that's gonna leave enough steps in the beginning to lay down the image composition, even text. The end can be 1 or 2 steps removed from the last step, and I noticed the video models subtract a couple steps. FluxDev just defaults to the final step. The final steps are generally refining and maybe the smallest details, so, you know, you choose what you need to do. But the real parameter here is threshold. Set it low to preserve quality and high to skip more steps. Around 0.2 or 0.25 is okay for average use. You should see faster render times, and when set high enough, you'll actually see the steps being skipped in the preview. But set it too high and the image quality will visibly suffer. If the threshold is too low, it could actually take longer to render because TeaCache is taking up resources, but it isn't skipping any steps. Now, most people are gonna set the threshold higher and try to render as fast as possible at worse quality. But if you're batch rendering, that's okay, because with TeaCache, the composition stays the same, mostly. That's why we start after 5 steps. I can go back and cherry-pick the good compositions from an overnight batch and re-render from that same seed at better quality. But the other strategy, if you just want better quality, increase your step count higher than usual, like a lot higher. If you usually use 30 steps, try 50 steps. Think of it as getting the quality of 50 steps for the cost of 30 or even less. The more steps TCash has to use, the more it can drop steps. It's counterintuitive, but you want to raise your step count so TCash has the wiggle room to work. Especially on video, those steps are spread across a lot of frames and you need the steps. So higher steps in video give smoother motion, and from my test, brighter contrast is just a better looking image. So render fast on the stuff that only you're going to see, test renders, batches, that sort of thing. And there you can crank it all the way to 1 and get the full speed benefit of TCache. But once you have the seed you like, drop TCache threshold back down to 0.2 or 0.15 and render it again at better quality. There's still probably going to be a lot of savings on the render time over a 30-step render, but you're getting much better quality, something closer to the look of 50 steps. That's all I have time for. So give this video a like if you think it will help others. And of course you can subscribe because there are a lot more videos on the way. Like I said, I got the one fun model coming up. That's a low overhead image to video. So subscribe. I'll see you next time. Oh, I'm supposed to say, can we rewrite these lines? I hope you had a learn.